Hi everyone, so in today's video I'm just going to be doing a quick little book review slash paint with me video, and I'm just going to be talking about this book that I actually just checked out today called Sweet Bean Paste by Duriyan Sakagawa or Sukagawa. I'm pretty sure I'm saying this name wrong. I'll just put where you can get the book, like off Amazon or some kind of book website wherever people buy books from, and I'm sure if you have a library near you, I'm pretty sure it will be there as well. But yeah, I'll put that in the description, and yeah, let's just talk about this book. So yeah, I haven't finished the book yet. I'm halfway through it, but so far it's really, really, really good. And I actually watched a video that recommended this book, and I'll link that in the description as well. But yeah, I was just really fascinated by the illustration on the cover. I think that's the main reason why I was like, ooh, I really want this book, because the illustration just looks like something I would do. And so, I don't know, I really like the contemporary kind of calm, like, illustrative. And this was also described as a contemporary fiction, which that is like my favorite genre right now. I'm really, really like getting out of the YA genre and like getting more into contemporary fiction. I feel like I'm 18 now, but I just feel like I've read enough YA throughout middle school and like high school, and it's just like kind of the same story over and over again. But this book, Sweet Bean Paste, is not like any book I've read before, actually. So the book takes place in Japan, and it follows this man called Sentaro, and it follows his life, like basically owning this pastry shop where they sell these pancake type things filled with sweet bean paste, and they are called dorayaki in Japanese, dorayaki. So they're referred to a lot in the book, actually. But so he comes across this old lady. She goes to the shop and is looking for a job and is like, hey, like, I really want to work here. And he kind of rejects her over and over because she's older, she's crippled, you know, her hand, she has like really crooked fingers, kind of like arthritis, but it's later revealed to be a disease called Hansen's disease. Pretty sure that's what it's called, Hansen's disease. But anyways, she ends up working there after she gives him some of her sweet bean paste, and he is completely blown away by how good it is, and he's like, wow, like, I've never tasted any bean paste like this before. And so he really wants her to work there because he thinks that her bean paste will really up the sales and up the customers that come in, and, you know, it'll be good for the business. So he basically hires her, and she comes in every morning before the shop opens and makes the bean paste. So some things end up happening where she ends up quitting. She ends up going back to where she's been living, which is kind of like a concentration camp. They don't refer to it as a concentration camp, but it's where they've quarantined all these people with Hansen's disease because supposedly it's contagious. I mean, they found a cure for it in recent years in the book, and I'm not sure if this is based off of true events or not, but they found a cure for it, but people who were quarantined during the time of the outbreak were still living in their communities because they had no family left. I mean, after so many years, your family dies off and people don't want to be around you anymore. And so it's just all these circumstances, really sad circumstances, actually. But she ends up going back to her concentration camp community type thing, and Sentaro and a young girl that comes to the shop pretty often, I think her name is Wakana, they end up visiting Yoku. Her name's Yoku, the older lady. No, her name's Toku. The older woman's name is Toku. So Sentaro and Wakana end up visiting Toku at her community. And while they're there, Toku pretty much just walks them through her whole life story, like how she got there, what it was like when she was first diagnosed, and how she was ripped away from her family. And it was just really heart-wrenching to read, like just thinking about a 14-year-old girl like going through all of that. And then she later goes on to tell us about her husband. She had a husband who died from heart troubles or heart disease or something like that. but everyone who is contaminated in that community aren't allowed to be buried in normal cemeteries. So they're all buried within the community. So they go to the place where everyone is buried, and they're basically having a like connection with her husband, her deceased husband. And it's not like a literal, it's not like paranormal, it's not sci-fi, so it's not a literal like communication or connection with the husband. But Sentaro describes how he felt the presence of the husband and all the other deceased, you know, quarantine patients who were buried in this community. And it was just really a beautiful feeling that was described. And I don't know if it's just me, but I can't help but to feel what is being described to me in books. Like whenever someone is like describing their pain or like their grief, I feel that like personally. And I think that's why I like reading so much. It probably makes reading so much more interesting, but it also sucks because I cannot get through a book without crying. Anyways, so yeah, Sentaro describes this feeling, and it was just a really beautiful scene in the book. And that's pretty much as far as I've gotten. I feel like I might finish this book either tonight or tomorrow, and maybe I'll do another paint with me kind of video and introduce another book while also concluding this book. So yeah, if you guys want more videos like this, actually no one watches my videos. I don't know why I'm like, oh, if you guys want to, I honestly just make videos for me and I just really enjoy the process of making videos and like kind of just talking about things that I like. It's just really like, I don't really have people to talk to like this too. Like people aren't really into the things I'm into, so making videos is like, it's kind of like I have someone to like brag about and like gossip about like books and like art and like all this nerdy stuff that I'm into. But yeah, if you are watching this video, thank you. And if you do enjoy my videos, thanks. But yeah, I really appreciate it. Anyways, I'm probably gonna do a lot more videos like this, so yeah. Thank you for watching if you made it this far, and I will let Painting Hannah do her thing and continue her picture. And if you want to leave and you just came for the book review, then do that. Just don't forget to like. But if you want to finish watching me paint and watch me finish this painting, then I hope you enjoy.